Hello, today we are going to be cleaning this Roborock Qrevo. It comes with the robot itself as well as the docking station. In the first video, we're going to clean the robot. The tools for the job are fairly simple. You really need a toothbrush, a wet or damp cloth or paper towel, a screwdriver, small Phillips-drive, or also known as number one Phillips-drive, and if you're going to be replacing any parts, such as a side brush, you can of course have that as well. The first thing that we're going to do is we are going to open this cover here to take out the dustbin. You can turn off the robot if you'd like, but really you could also leave it on, it doesn't matter. What you're going to do is you're going to take a look where that dustbin was. Notice there's probably quite a bit of grit there, and you're going to clean it out. You can of course use another vacuum cleaner to do it, or you can just shake it out. It really depends how much it needs to be cleaned. This was really not that bad in this case. Okay. For the dustbin itself, you'll notice there's a flap here, and you have a filter here, another couple flaps over there. What you want to do is you want to push here with your thumb to take the filter out. What we're going to do now is we're going to take out any remaining debris that might be in this dustbin. And then after that, we are going to wash this dustbin along with the filter. You can see that even though the dustbin is empty, the filter is quite clogged. So we are definitely going to wash this out. When we wash it, make sure to have the water go in all directions, so both flowing through here as well as flowing at an angle this way, so that all the dust gets pushed out, just like that. But before we go to clean the dustbin under the sink, we are going to take the brush out. What we're going to do is you're going to squeeze these two buttons here to open this lid. Set that aside, and then you can simply pull this brush right up. You'll notice there's a bit of dust on the brush, and there might also be some hair on the ends. In order to get that off, what you do is you simply pull this black end piece off, and then you should be able to have decent access to it. It depends, really. You might not even need to pull that off. If you have hair there, then pull it off. If not, you'd be okay. And from there, you can really go ahead and get in there better and try to access that hair. Sometimes you might have one of these hooks that come with certain replacement parts. If you have one of them, you can go ahead and use them to get rid of that hair. They work pretty well. You can also, of course, just use a toothbrush or a screwdriver to pry that out. Either way, you have options. Okay, that's ready. We're gonna also go ahead and wash this brush in the sink to get all that dust off of it. Now, we're also going to take a look at this area over here. If this wheel has a lot of hair on it or anything like that, you could actually take it out. All you have to do is squeeze it and give it a good pull. Sometimes it'll come right out, sometimes it'll give you some trouble. In this case, I am actually having some trouble removing it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my screwdriver, try to pry it a little bit. There we go. Came right out. If you had any hair, you would be able to take it off, but in this case, this is fairly clean. Additionally, if you had any hair wrapped around this center area, all you'd have to do is rotate it until you see the little screw there, and then you could take it out and remove the hair. But like I said, that's pretty unusual. I'm going to push this back in. You should hear two clicks when that's fully engaged.
The mops you could also wash as well. To take the mop heads out, you simply lift them straight up, just like that. Same thing here. Just lift them right out. There's really nothing special about it. You replace those as needed. I'm probably going to wash these now, but if they were due for replacement, I would also replace them. I'm now going to take my wet paper towel and I'm just going to clean the area where the brush sits and make that all nice and clean. Finally, you might also have some hair here underneath the side brush. If you did, you'd take your screwdriver, you'd hold the side brush with your hand to keep it from rotating, and you'd undo the screw. Then you could check for any hair on the bottom and remove it. You could also replace the side brush if it needed to be replacing. This one probably still has a little bit of life left. The Roborock is not actually telling me I need to replace it yet, so although it looks a little dirty, I'm going to keep it for now until its time is actually up. To put it back, notice that there is a hexagon shape here and here, so you're just going to put it down until the hexagon engages, just like that. Restrain the brush with your hand and reinstall the screw. Okay. All right. I'm now going to go ahead and wipe the sensors. So there are sensors all down here at the bottom. You can see them right here. I just wiped these four there. Again, this is just a damp paper towel, nothing special. I'm going to wipe the sensor here on the back. Wipe the contacts. These are the electrical contacts for recharging the Roborock. Might even take a look at this hole. That's where the water fills up. If you need to, you could clean that as well. Just take a look at how dirty it is. This sensor here, I'm gonna wipe. The main front sensor. The laser sensors on the top, we typically don't wipe unless you have some kind of special circumstance. They're also hard to get to because they're way deep in there. So we're gonna leave those be. You should not need to mess with those. Just kind of wipe the top over in general. And let's see, there's also the dust port over here where the filter empties. We're going to clean that as well because that tends to have some dirt buildup just around it. All right, that's it for wiping the robot down. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this retaining lid for the brush. I'm going to leave this here. I'm going to bring the brush, the retaining lid for it, the two mops, the filter, and the filter housing over to the sink and give them a good wash. I am also going to bring my toothbrush to get into all these grooves here to be able to clean that well. And then that's about it. Then after that, we'll be able to reinstall. Okay, so of course the next step would be to let everything dry thoroughly before you go to install anything. However, just for the purposes of the demonstration, I will show you how to install it now while it's wet, but of course I will, right after this video, take it all back out to let it dry. So, the dustbin. What you do to put the filter back in once it's dry is you'll notice there are a couple of features here, one, two, and on the other side, just one. The two features here that kind of, you'll see, stick out over here. This has two little tabs, the filter. You line them up just like that. And then you push down where there's the one central tab. Just like that. It really doesn't take much effort at all. Again, two tabs on the edge, one, two. Line up with two tabs here. That's it. Then after that, you open the compartment. Line it up such that the hole that goes into the robot lines up with the hole here with this special shaped hole. And you put it in that manner to put it in. Close, simple. On the other side, again, once they're dry, this is just for the demonstration, the mop heads couldn't be any easier. You just put them in, line them up. You might have to move it around a little bit. Move it around, put them in, you're done. That's easy. Okay, for the brush here, if you did have to take off this little black piece, as I did, when you put it back on, what you're going to do is make sure that the brass colored or copper colored piece goes on first, like that, and push until you hear a click. That's it. Now, you'll see that there's, again, a hexagon shape over here, if you look at it this way. And over here, there's a square shape where this white piece is. And on the other side, there's kind of a half a hexagon shape. So what you're going to do is the hexagon shape goes into the half a hexagon over here. And then the square here, there's also a square here on the other side. So not on the black tab, but the gray tab. You line the square up with the other square and then just let it fall in. It doesn't even click or anything. It just kind of drops in. Very, very simple. Now, finally, for the piece that goes in to cover everything up, if you just look at it, it's all kind of a square shape or rectangular shape, but then there's a corner that's kind of angled here. If you look at it this way, there's a corner that's angled right here. So what you do is you put it down just like that, push until it clicks. You're done. That's it. Very simple. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe. Thanks.